if everyone could come over just kind of out here for one second. So in a second, we're going to have two stations that are set up specifically for shooting. We'll have 1, 2, 3, 4 players working. Then I'll show you down there, we're going to do a puck handling thing. The neutral zone, we're going to keep for players that, if you want to grab Tyler or myself, maybe we'll continue to cross over to stop the starts or something a little bit more fundamental. That's what that neutral zone's for. So when we're at this station, let's go 2 or 3 in a row. Just treat it like a batting cage or like a driving range. We'll have a pile of pucks. All we're going to do is use the pass here. It's kind of cool. You get a good pass, it gives you a good pass back. If you're going to give it a traffic pass, we'll handle that. All we're going to do is we're working on sliding the pass. My hands are open, I catch it, and we're just going to work on straight wrist shots. If you want to take slap shots, that's fine. Grab myself or Tyler. Our hands are open, our blade is comfortably closed, and then if you're able to, if you can bend your stick or make it flex just a little bit, that's going to be your best friend. So if you push your stick and it feels like a 2x4, try to find a new one next time because that flex is really helpful. So all we do is we're going to catch it. The first thing that pops up is back of my stance, and leaving it like this. If you start with a long arm, you should be a pulling motion from your top hand. Your bottom hand should be pushing. So if you push and pull at the same time, that's how my stick bends and flexes. That, again, that's going to be super helpful. So all you're going to do, you're going to have a pile of pucks. All you're going to do is pass, catch it, put it to my lower position, pull a shot. I'll take another one, pass. The first thing, it goes to my loaded position, blade is closed. The second, think of, I don't know if you're golf or if you golf, think of the face of your driver. You open the face of your driver, you're hooking it in the next fairway. The same thing happens with your stick. Keep your blade, or the face of your blade closed. Pass it, catch it, my hands are in a good position, hold, close, stop. If I was on the other side, this is the exact same concept, but now I've got a swivel to put myself in a loaded position. And then you're just fluttering the puck, you're actually driving down. And if you took a bunch of slap shots, you should see the ice. I hit it, and that's how my stick bends. Not enough people really use it. And again, I'll be bouncing back and forth. This is kind of my strength, whereas Tyler's got great hands, he's going to be doing the hand stuff. So let's come over to this side real quick.
Give him room. But you're fine. You can go next. We'll just go this way.
No, I was getting out of the way.
Oh, you're good. Who says I didn't try?
A little secret too, I think it's a lot easier to keep that up towards the top of my backhand when I make my move.
Go ahead, man.
Thank you.
his girlfriend are practicing together.
He'll hear that on the tape.
What's that?
Yeah, it's real cute.
I didn't even think about your recording. Probably gonna be pissed when they hear me.
No, they won't. Yeah, just trying to get the balance in, man.
So the first two you did was too far away. You got to get that puck close to you. It's like
you're almost like you're pulling it in and letting it go.
That's it. You need to get. You can't put the weight on her. It's like sleeping.
Yeah. Good? You still going? What's that? Thanks.
Good
least we know your elbows work. You good? Did it hit you above the pad?
Yeah.
Sorry, brother.
Shit, that puck's too far behind you.
I'll face your slapper. Give yourself more space. Back up. Time it. Go ahead, man.
Go ahead. I'm good. Thank you.
Yes! It went in. What's that?
It's gone. Accidentally.
Say hi, Alex.
Hi.
See it?
Hi.
So for the sake of making the drill kind of work well, try to partner yourself up with, I don't know, some different teammates or someone that's kind of similar to your ability. It's a formula pass and stretch drill, so we're going to involve passing, skating, shooting. So in a second, we've got a pile of puck by the water fountain, and then a pile of puck down in this corner, a line here, and a line here, line here, and a line here. So on the whistle, two players are going to go. The player in the corner starts the puck. All you're going to do is just go down the ice, making little puck passes. We're skating two parallel lines. Somewhere at the red line, just hit the puck to the outside player. The outside player comes in and shoots, and then just go to the back of the line. With a big group, please like get into the corner so you're not in the kill zone behind the net. Yeah, it happens all the time. I'm going to throw a tire here and a tire here. The inside player, you're going to go around here. The next player, you should be calling for a puck. You're just going to get a pass right here. Then you come back down and shoot. The same thing, so on the whistle, two players, that's four total players that are all working together. The same thing, two players are going down the ice, couple touches, again, meet each other with the passes. Somewhere over here, the outside wall player, take it in and shoot. This is a good opportunity to now put motion into our shot. And it's kind of a simple equation, but the faster you skate into a shot, where your puck is gonna come off your blade at that speed. So say you skate 10 miles an hour, at a very minimum, if you shoot a puck 1 mile an hour, it's at least an 11 mile an hour shot. Faster you skate, the harder your shot's gonna be. And again, I think for this particular drill, I would feel more comfortable taking a puck and loading it, pulling into my shot, whether it's a wrist or a snapshot, skating and then half clapping it, probably is not the most effective way here, plus it's dangerous. And then whenever you take a slap shot, your stick comes off the ice, now you've juggled timing. So now you gotta hope that the puck stays in your stance, and it takes a lot more skill than just keeping it on our blade, pointing and shooting. And then again, the inside pointers are